In this installment of TCPIP Basics, we are going to talk about ANDing, IP addresses using binary. So what is ANDing? It seems kind of an odd name. So the idea of ANDing is to determine whether or not two IP addresses are in the same subnet. So can they communicate with each other without the use or the need for a router? ANDing is going to tell us, and it's a simple math formula, and it uses what's called Boolean logic. So this is Boolean logic. Boolean logic was actually named after an actual person came up with this a long time ago. So it's simple. We use binary. Zeros and ones. That's all it is. So this is a simple part of the equation. 0 plus 0 equals 0. So far you're on board. 0 plus 1 equals 0 as well. Well, that doesn't sound normal, does it? Well, in Boolean logic, it is. The only thing that actually adds up to a number above zero is when you add 1 plus 1. But it doesn't equal 2 like you would expect. It actually equals 1. So why is that? That's because things are either on or off. There is no third state. There is no kind of on or kind of off. So that's why you only have two options. So can these two IPs communicate? That is our goal. Are they in the same subnet? So let's start out with this example. 10.1.1.200. And the CIDR is /24. So this is what it looks like in binary. So if you took the 10, you would know from previous videos how to convert decimal to binary. If you missed that, go back into the playlist and watch this first. Watch that video first before you come back and take a look at this. So the /24 is represented as 24 ones followed by 8 zeros, because once again, IPv4 is 32-bit. Got to subtract 24 from that, and we end up with 8 zeros. So if we AND these together, we can see what the result is. So this is the result if you put 0 plus 0 equals 0, 0 plus 1 equals 0, and 1 plus 1 equals 1. So we do see some ones here because there are some ones that match up. Now let's take a second address because, again, we want to see whether these two IP addresses can communicate. Our second address is 10.1.150. And it's also a /24. And we see, once again, binary equivalent for 10.1.150 followed by the 24 ones followed by the 8 zeros. We AND those together, and you see what we get. Do they match? Yes, they match. So as long as they're between 1 and 254, they match. We used ANDing to find out that two IP addresses would be able to communicate with each other without a router. That's all it is. That's what ANDing is. So let's take a look at another example. Can these two IPs communicate? 32, 15, 7, and 20, /16. So if we do this in binary, we see what 32, 15, 7, 20 is, followed by a /16. So we can see 16 ones followed by 16 zeros, because 32 minus 16 equals 16. And this is what it looks like in binary after you've done your ANDing. Now let's take a second address, 32.15.200.1. And we can see what it is in both binary as well as the subnet mask. And there's the results. So are they in the same subnet? Do they match? Yes, they match. So here it is in the power of 2 if you wanted to do it that way. And we can see 7.20, yes, it is in the same subnet, the same LAN, as 200.1. So very good. Once again, it worked. Let's look at a third example. Are these two IPs able to communicate? 32.15.7.20/16. And we can see it in binary. And now we see the /16 spelled out in binary as well. And we do our ANDing. There's the results. 001 followed by zeros, and then you see the rest of it there. Now let's do another address, 32.16.200.1, also a /16. There's our binary written out for 32.16.200.1. There's once again our subnet mask, same thing. And now we see the ANDing results. Do they look the same? No, the Boolean results do not match. They cannot communicate. They are not in the same subnet. So now we've used ANDing in this example as well to see that they cannot communicate. So the anding process is actually very helpful, and you will definitely be asked these types of questions on certification tests like the Network Plus exam. So keep anding in mind what it does and how it works and what it accomplishes. It accomplishes just this: can these IP addresses communicate?